Hi, I'm Shannon with Morrison's Rogue Wilderness Adventures. We are so excited to welcome you to one of our multi-day adventures on the gorgeous Rogue River. We find many of our customers have questions about their trip before they arrive, so we put together this video for you to answer some of those questions. Questions like, how do you even get here? And once you're here, where should you stay? And where should you stay the night after your trip? What should you wear and what should you pack and how should you pack it all? Does technology even work in the canyon? Once your trip is over, how do you get back to your car or your hotel? And if you want to continue your vacation from that point, where should you go? We can and will answer all of those questions, so let's get started. The first question you probably have is, how do you even get to Morrison's Rogue Wilderness Adventures? We are located just outside the tiny town of Merlin, Oregon. If you're driving, you're probably taking Interstate 5. So take exit 61 and head west. You'll go 12 miles through the tiny town of Merlin. Morrison's Rogue Wilderness Adventures is on the right. If you're flying, you can fly into the Medford Airport. It's the Rogue Valley International Medford Airport, MFR, if you're Googling it. If you need a shuttle, let us know. We do offer that service. And if you have your own plane, Merlin has its own tiny municipal airport. Okay, so now that you know how to get here, the questions are, when should you get here and where should you stay? Well, we need you to be here the afternoon before your trip, and ideally you will stay at Morrison's Rogue River Lodge. That's where your orientation the evening before your trip will be held. At that orientation, you'll meet your head guide and your fellow river travelers and have any more questions you may have answered. We'll also be giving you some gear, a couple of dry bags, a small one that you'll put the items you want to access during the day in, and then a larger one that's about 2 feet by 3 feet, and you can put all your clothing in there along with all the items that you need at night at the lodges or if you're camping. Just keep in mind, if you bring a duffel or some other soft-sided suitcase, you can slide the whole thing in that dry bag. Please don't use hard-shelled suitcases or anything with wheels. So now it's time to pack, and you're wondering what you should be wearing. First, plan on dressing in layers of loose, durable clothing. We don't recommend cotton, though. Cotton doesn't dry very quickly, nor does it wick moisture away from your skin. So if you get wet and cold, you stay wet and cold. If you're looking for special materials, look for polypropylene and capylene. Both work well. Lots of people think the Rogue River is cold enough for a wetsuit, but not so. The Rogue is one of the warmest rivers in the West. But if you're cold-blooded like I tend to be sure to bring some fleece along, too. As for footwear, no flip-flops. You'll want to wear something that attaches to your foot around the ankle, like a Chaco or a Teva, a sports sandal. Or if you have an old pair of tennis shoes you don't mind getting wet, that works well too. Or water socks or booties. If you don't have any of those items, don't sweat it. We do sell them in our gift shop. Of course, we want you to be comfortable, so don't forget to bring sunscreen, a hat, either one that fits tightly to your head or has a strap to keep it on. The morning of your trip, after your hearty breakfast at Morrison's Rogue River Lodge, you'll meet the rest of your guides and get fitted for your life jacket. Each trip includes a combination of boats, oar boats, paddle boats, and inflatable kayaks, also known as IKs or duckies. You'll get a chance to try out all of them during your trip. The Rogue River is a pool and drop river, which means after each rapid, there's a pool below. The international scale for whitewater rafting is class 1 through 6, 1 being calm, 6 being death-defying. The Rogue River averages class 3, with gentle, exciting whitewater throughout the trip. If your trip has you staying in lodges, you may be wondering about the lodges. Well, first, no, they're all very different, but they're all very clean. They provide towels and linens and great food. You will be very well fed. You should know, however, that all of the lodges are off the grid, which means please don't bring anything like curling irons or hair dryers that need to be plugged in. You'll blow the power system. If you need to bring a CPAP machine, please look into getting a battery. If you'd like to learn more about the lodges, you can look them up online. We'll be staying at Black Bar, Paradise, and Mariel Lodge. If you're on a fishing trip, you may also be staying in Lucas Lodge. If you're camping, all you have to bring is yourself, your clothing, and a small or camp-sized pillow. We'll provide everything else for you, including your tent, your sleeping bag, and a sleeping pad called a Paco pad. You do have the option of upgrading to our deluxe camping package, which includes a larger tent, a cot with mattress, sleeping bag, and a pillow. Many of our camping guests are concerned that we'll put them to work. Don't worry, we won't do anything of the kind. When you arrive at camp in the afternoons, camp will already be set up for you, so you and your family and friends can relax on your riverside oasis while our guides start preparing dinner. As for alcohol, no, we won't provide any for you unless you're on a trip that specifies wine will be included. You are, however, welcome to bring whatever you like. We'll have a cooler set aside specifically for guest beverages, and we'll carry that down the river for you. And if you want, Paradise Lodge provides beer and alcohol, so be sure to have cash on hand if you're interested in that option. Now we come to the best part of any vacation, the food. We have a commercial kitchen on site, so we spend days ahead of your trip, baking and cooking in preparation for you and your fellow travelers. So please, if you have any food considerations, maybe you're vegetarian or vegan, gluten-free, or especially allergic to something, please let us know so we can have food for you. On the last day of your trip, you'll take off the water around 1 o'clock at Foster Bar. Our vans and trailers will be there to meet you and bring you back to Morrison's Lodge, where you started your journey. You also have the option of having your car shuttled to Foster Bar, so when you come off the water, you can just hop in your vehicle and continue your vacation. Many guests choose that option and then drive the 30 or so miles to the coast. If you're flying out after your trip, please make plans to do so the day after you come off the water. It's really hard to get to the Medford Airport in time for an evening flight the day your trip ends. We hope we've answered a few of your questions, but we know there are a million more. So please read through the itinerary and the registration forms we sent you in your confirmation email. If you still have more questions, go ahead and call us. We'd love to talk to you. And until then, just know we cannot wait to introduce you to Oregon's beautiful, wild and scenic Rogue River.